And then in 1990s, he was elected as the Amir of Jamaat-e-Islami, Bangladesh. He continued to work in that capacity as the Central Amir in 2000. He was elected as the Member of Parliament several times because he was a very popular political leader. He served as a federal minister in the cabinet of Bangladesh at least two times. He was actually, as a very ironical thing, one of the founders of the Constitution of Bangladesh. I'm talking about Brother Motiur Rahman Nizami. With all the injustice in the world, we saw the max of injustice which can happen to someone who claims to be a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right in this day and age. He sacrificed his life, he was executed this month. I'm very honored to invite his son, Brother Nakibur Rahman, to come over and receive his recognition award. Brother Nakibur Rahman.
He was executed right after midnight in Bangladesh, which was 2 p.m. our time. I got a call from Brother Dr. Shahid Motiur, and he told me that if I'm home or not. I'm like, yes, I'm home. And he's like, me and Brother Naeem Beg want to come over. I do not live very close from Virginia, where Brother Shahid and Brother Naeem Beg lives. I live in the woods of North Carolina, which is 350 miles from their residence. So that shows the love and commitment, and that love is just for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I'm very, very grateful to ICNA, to our brothers and sisters who showed tremendous love. And I would like to share one more thing. On the 6th of May this year, 7 days before my father, 5 days before my father was executed, my mom called me, and they paid the second last visit to my father. And my mom was telling me about a dream my father saw. He was a very humble person. He always referred to him as a grassroots worker activist. And he was born in a small village, which was on the bank of a river. So my father saw a dream a few days before 6, and that's what he shared with my mom. And the dream was something like my father was sitting on the bank of the river, and the river is very calm. All of a sudden, there were all kinds of waves that was created on the river. And my mom, being a very optimistic person, was hoping that there may be means, inshallah, someday my father will be freed, and there will be people gathering all around him. Little did we know, his dream came true. When my father was executed, government planned to bury him in the middle of the night, but they couldn't take his body to our village until 7 in the morning. So as soon as his dead body arrived in our little village, despite mass arrest, despite roadblocks, thousands of people gathered around at 7 in the morning to pray his janazah. And my brother was saying that if you were not there, you wouldn't believe what a sea and wave of of people need. You could see people as far as your eye goes. And that was not it. People were walking because their cars were blocked. People were walking miles. There were 26 janaza prayed on that day. And each janaza were bigger than the other. And it didn't even stop there. We are really grateful to world leader President Tayyip Erdogan because he pulled out the ambassador of Turkey the very next day. At every event, he couldn't stop talking about my father. And the wave continues right here in Baltimore. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum.